intervention that this can happen. People are too at odds. The distrust is so too thoroughgoing because of this. These front groups have basically set up too much distrust among the people by their.
But you know, Lino, there's another element to this, and I do stay on the line. I want to send you a copy of Government Zero. I should have started giving them out today. Stay on the line for Government Zero. You know, there was a time in Italy's history when all higher authority was corrupt. The government was corrupt. The church was corrupt. And that's the period during which the so-called mafia originated. Did you know that? It's when people banded together in sort of tribal, first families and then tribes, to defend themselves against corrupt governments and corrupt church officials. We have now reached a point in America under this very evil president of ours. We know the government is totally corrupt. We know it's corrupt from top to bottom. And now we see that the church, we can't turn to the church. It's also been corrupted by communism. Do you understand how corrupt this is? Why do I say that the government is corrupt? Well, you've heard a thousand things about it. Here's a new one. It came out minutes ago. Hold on to your chairs. The Army just rejected an appeal from a Green Beret who was thrown out of the Army after confronting an accused Afghan rapist. Your Army's been taken over by gays and lesbians, in case you don't know it. And now Obama wants to add insult to injury and further go after the morale of the U.S. Army by appointing the first openly homosexual Army secretary. You say, well, all right, well, that's not so bad. What does he have to say about ignoring Afghan child abusers? What is the new Army secretary? What would he have to say, rather? He hasn't been appointed yet. The stooge government has to stamp him. What would the new secretary, the gay secretary, the great humanitarian, have to say about this 11-year Green Beret who was thrown out of the Army after he confronted an alleged rapist in Afghanistan? He was thrown out November 1st. He's been fighting to stay in. But the U.S. Army Human Resources Command, you know what that is, don't you? Human Resources Command? Just try to envision what they look like. Told the Green Beret Martland that his appeal does not meet the criteria for an appeal. And so they threw him out of the Army today. It happened just now. Just now, here's a Green Beret who stood up for a young boy who was screaming as he was being raped by one of those Afghani throwbacks. See, that's what they do in Afghanistan. That's part of the Army culture amongst the Muslim soldiers who our men have been forced to fight alongside these vermin, these primitive, ugly, deceitful vermin. They rape boys in Afghanistan when they have the power to do so. So our men, our good men, heard the screams and the cries of the boys, and they try to stop the guy. And guess what? They threw the Green Beret out of the military. That's your Obama. That's your commander-in-chief. God in heaven, do you understand what's going on right in front of your eyes? It's one combat veteran after another that's being dismissed by the new military, the new corrupt military. The government's corrupt, the church is corrupt, and now they're corrupting the military. Tell us what's left. Think about it. Back in a minute.
Join the Savage Nation. Call now, 855-400-SAVAGE, 855-400-7282.
Savage.
My Savage Nation is sponsored by SwissAmerica.com, the only company I trust to protect my wealth with gold and silver. Call 800-BUYCOIN. I've been talking about the Pope and the Marxist agenda. I've been showing you the radical Catholicism that's involved in this. I've shown you the money trail. I've told you about the great wealth of the Catholic Church and the utter hypocrisy of this Pope's messaging when he himself sits upon one of the greatest hoards of great art and gold and real estate holdings in the world and doesn't give it away to the poor. Unto itself, the hypocrisy should make you not laugh, but ignore this fraud. And now, on top of all of that fraudulent garbage, sits the pile of rubbish called global warming and the false science thereof from a man who knows nothing about science. So why would the church suddenly get involved in the global warming scam? Why? Because follow the money. Fortunes have been made on the global warming scam since Obama took office. Fortunes that you could never imagine. It's like organized crime without guns. As I said to you, there's more money in green than there is in heroin. And you have to understand that fortunes are being made as we speak. Fortunes will be made in the future on this fraud, trying to undo the actual history of science, the actual history of climatology is ignored. All the ice ages and the following cooling and the warming and the cooling and the warming. I'm not arguing for pollution. You know, if you know me, that I've spent many years in very valid scientific and environmental work. My botanical collections are so exquisite. They are housed in 7 of the principal scientific museums in the world, from Leningrad to Tokyo. I know more about the environment than Nancy Pelosi, Al Gore, the Pope, and the President put together. Understand what's going on.
Join the Savage Nation. Call now, 855-400-SAVAGE, 855-400-7282.
Savage.
I feel a lot lighter today because His Holiness has arrived in Washington, D.C. on an air-conditioned Alitalia A320. And I feel we are blessed to have in our presence such a holy man who has come from nowhere to lead the world out of its ignorance. Let's see what's in the news. Let's go to michaelsavage.com. I don't know what I put up today. INR. Top right. Army rejects appeal from soldier discharged after confronting accused boy rapist in Afghanistan. Well, he's not a soldier. He's a Green Beret with 11 years. That's a terrible headline. Pope Francis, critic of capitalism since 1990s. Good friend of Castro. Poll, 51% of U.S. Muslims want Islamic law. 25% of U.S. Muslims okay with violence against infidels. They're building up a civil war like you can never imagine, bringing in millions of them now. Remember the Dallas bomb boy? Well, he's on the way to Mecca. His father pulled him out of school because he doesn't like the school that was shocked that he'd built a clock that looks like a bomb. Built a clock that looked like a bomb, so everyone got freaked out. Well, naturally, that's the narrative of racism to Obama, and Obama has invited him to the White House. He has not yet, so far as I know, invited any American military heroes recently to the White House, but he invited this little boy, Dallas bomb boy, on way to Mecca with his father and then to Obama. Huh. For those of you who like history, I put up a history of the Muslim conquest of Sicily, because I know some very, very intelligent people who are very worried about our current invasion and the conquest of America. They say, "What? How are we going to survive this?" And I tell them, look, you can't change the course of history. The only thing that could stop this would be the immediate impeachment and imprisonment of the president and a rollback of all of his insane policies. Try to get to John Boehner if you can get through the whiskey bottles. And I showed the Muslim conquest of Sicily, which began in 827 and lasted until 902. That's a long time. Did you know that? Although Sicily had been raided by the Muslims since the mid-7th century. It's an interesting story from Wikipedia. It's very well done. Muslim conquest of Sicily. And I use it as an example of a nation that was conquered repeatedly, not only by Muslims, but by many other nations, even though Muslim is not a nation, I get it, but many other, let's say, peoples, put it to you that way, over the years. One after the other conquered Sicily, and Sicily still survived. It's still there. People have to live through these things. You have to live through the conquest that's ongoing right in front of your eyes. That's a heck of a statement. You're being conquered right in front of your eyes. The conquest started with the illegal aliens from Mexico. They warned us they were going to do it. Aztlan, La Micha. I was warning you about this in the 1990s when I began in radio. La Micha, Aztlan. They said that they were reconquistadors. They were going to take back what they felt was Mesoamerican lands. Well, they've done so, and they're doing so, and they continue to do so. So you are watching an invasion from the south. Now you're watching an invasion from the Middle East. Your country is being hit by successive waves of invaders. I realize if Donald Trump said this, it would really get the Larry Davids of the world insane. But I'm only a talk show host with a very small audience of millions. And so they ignore me. They ignore me for a number of reasons. One, because they use the Soviet tactic, which is by ignoring people, you do them more harm, they think, than by attacking them. Well, keep ignoring me because millions don't. Keep ignoring me because millions still buy my books and listen to my shows, irrespective of what the opposition may try to do to me. And so I warn you, you're being conquered. Just as Sicily was hit by waves of conquest, we're being hit by waves of conquest. Only in the old days, it was done by war. In the new days, it's being done by fear, intimidation. Maoism, remember I talked about Maoism last Friday, about how they first take down the culture, change the history, wipe out the history, and they then intimidate people with threats. And so although they're not beating you if you don't go along with the political correctness of the time, where you dare not say what's true, they take your job away, they don't give you a scholarship, they fail you in a classroom. That's conquest. It's not done through the barrel of a gun. Now it's done through the lens of a camera. Remember Mao Zedong said power comes from the barrel of a gun? In America, power comes through the lens of an iPhone. Michael Savage. That's not bad. It's a pretty good one. And so look at the fall of Palermo, expansion of the Muslim invasion of Italy, what went on after that. On and on and on. Muslim capture of Malta and Syracuse. You thought Syracuse, New York came from Syracuse, New York. You didn't know where Syracuse came from. The fall of Syracuse to the Arabs. Dissension among the Sicilian Muslims. Ibrahim II's arrival and the fall of Taormina, 901. It's an amazing history. And it's just what goes on. Nations come and nations go. Never before, though, in human history has a nation been so successfully invaded without a shot being fired by an invading army. Never before in the history of man has a people of so large a nation just given up its nation without fighting back. Never. It's never happened before. Usually a nation is conquered through war, and a nation then gives up if it loses a war. We haven't had a war, have we? And yet we've been conquered. Now we're getting hit from another front. First it was from an invasion from the south. Now we're getting hit by an invasion from the Middle East. Again, under the guise of humanitarianism, you can get away with anything. Oh, please, I'm a refugee. Let me in. Oh, please, let me and my little baby in. That's why 70% of them are military-age Muslims being brought into the country for what? To make clocks? What are they coming in as clockmakers? What are they coming here for? You mean we have massive jobs waiting for them? You mean factories are waiting to employ all these unemployable men that can't speak the language? How are they going to work in this country? Who's going to pay for them? Who's going to support them? Another invasion. Now, in Europe, they finally woke up. They're putting up barriers. They're putting the military on their borders. It took them weeks to stop the Muslim invasion. I don't know whether they're going to succeed, but they put up some barriers. And here, hey, Obama waved his finger. Magic scepter. Went from 10,000 to 200,000 over a weekend. It'll be 2 million before he's finished, before the election. That's all. Now we wake up and here we are. Now we are, many of you turn to religion in times like this. Like, oh, I can't take politics. I can't take it anymore. I'll turn to God. And you go into the church and everywhere you turn now, you got a political message. This has been going on for a long time in some of the liberal denominations and in other religions. Every other sermon is about the environment or about gays or lesbians or refugees and immigrants. Nothing about God. You go into a Reformed Jewish temple today, there's very little God and there's an awful lot of progressivism in place of God. Well, now you have a progressive pope arrives on our shores. Get ready for the malarkey to be thrown over the next 2 days. And the only salvation in all of this is to watch the charade with amusement. Watch all of the atheists in the media who have mocked religion their entire career. Watch them how they behave with this quote holy man. Just wait until you see. I'm going to ask you as a homework assignment, because I'm taking tomorrow off. I have a very able person filling in. Brian from the morning show on KSFO will be here to hold down the Savage Fortress. I'm going to be talking to God all day tomorrow. I don't know where, but I'm going to be talking to God, probably sitting and looking at the water, whatever. I need a day to reflect and think about, collect, as I say, collect myself That's a funny statement unto itself.